Welcome viewers, welcome to AP's 5-Minute Ophthalmology Pearls. Watch, understand and remember anything in ophthalmology in under 5 minutes. Today we will be talking about the concept and mechanism of diplopia. Each point on the retina has a particular visual direction. For example, for the fovea, the visual direction is straight ahead. That means that if the rays from an object fall on the fovea, it is interpreted by the brain as being straight ahead with respect to that eye. When seeing with both eyes, the rays from an object that is straight ahead fall on the fovea of both eyes and is interpreted as being straight ahead and is seen as a single object. Rays from an object to the left of the straight ahead position fall on the retina to the right of the fovea in both eyes. This is because light travels in straight lines. So the rays fall on the temporal retina in the right eye and on the nasal retina in the left eye. Thus the brain interprets this object as single and lying to the left of the straight ahead position. So now it is obvious that every object in space falls on one point in each retina, both of which give the same visual direction. These two points, one in each eye, are referred to as corresponding retinal points. So, corresponding retinal points are defined as areas on each retina that share the same subjective visual direction. So, the two fovea are corresponding retinal points. These two are corresponding retinal points. Every point in the retina of one eye has a corresponding retinal point in the retina of the other eye. If the point is on the nasal retina of one eye, its corresponding point is on the temporal retina of the other eye and vice versa. Now what happens when there is an ocular deviation? Let us say the right eye has got a convergent squint. Now the image of the object falls on the fovea of the left eye, but on a non-corresponding point in the right eye. The visual direction for this point is temporal to the straight ahead position, and so the brain interprets it as such. Thus, two images are seen, one from the undeviated eye straight ahead and one temporal to it, thus giving rise to diplopia. So diplopia can be defined as the perception of two images of the same object due to stimulation of non-corresponding or disparate retinal points. Notice that the false image is not as clear as the true image. This is because the rays fall on an extra foveal point where vision is not as sharp as a foveal image. Also, the false image is on the same side as the deviated eye. This is referred to as uncrossed diplopia or homonymous diplopia. Now let us see what happens when the right eye has got a divergent squint. The rays fall on an extrafoveal point which is on the temporal retina. This is projected to the nasal field and so diplopia is produced. But this time the false image is on the opposite side as the deviated eye, that is right eye, but false image is the left side one. This is termed as cross diplopia or heteronymous diplopia. So in exotropia, you get a crossed diplopia. This is an easy mnemonic that you can remember. So in a convergent squint, also termed esotropia, you get an uncrossed diplopia. And in a divergent squint, also called exotropia, you get a crossed diplopia. That is why in a third nerve palsy or oculomotor palsy, you get a crossed diplopia. And in a fourth nerve or trochlear nerve palsy and a sixth nerve or abducens nerve palsy, you get an uncrossed diplopia. So that's it for now. If you like what you saw, please give this video a like, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to never miss an update from AP's 5-Minute Ophthalmology Pearls. Please leave a note in the comment section if you wish for any particular topic to be covered in future. Look forward to weekly updates. Thank you for watching.